If you have a lot of cables lying around your house, you probably have thought to yourself at one time or another, I wish I had a wireless charging stand. Hello, I am Wanderer001, and this is my review of the Anker Wireless Charger with Power Adapter, or the PowerWave II Stand. This is a wireless charging stand from Anker. And when I say wireless, if this is your first time actually looking into a wireless device, it means that your phone will not have any wires plugged into it. You will still need to plug in the charging stand in order to use it. So you can see the plug in the back there. Just want to get that out of the way up front because I had a time explaining this to somebody else and that came up. So just know, you do need to actually plug in the stand. While we talk about that, we'll quickly bring into frame. This is the DC power adapter for the stand. It has a 5-foot cable that plugs into the back right here. And now this is how it normally will look for you. I will say that the 5-foot cable, it for most will give you a decent amount of reach if you're using this at your desk or in your office situation. For me, I have found this very effective while doing reviews here. Generally, I will keep it slightly off frame and have my cell phone in the cradle because that's what I'm using now for my notes. And if I need to charge my phone, I don't have to worry because I have the stand. And even if I don't want to charge, I can just unplug it and use it as a stand. We will take that out the back right there. Up front, you have a small LED indicator light. When you have a compatible device touching the back here, it will light up blue. Coming around to the back, there only is the DC plug. On the bottom here, you have this nice rubberized foot, which helps it stay in place. Speaking of rubberized foot, you also have one where your phone sits. I will say the thing that I did not particularly care about this is this rubber foot really feels cheaply put in place. After the first time I used it, I noticed that the corner was coming up. And again, that is harping over something that I realize is a very small, nuanced thing. It's not that important. But if you're going to have your phone on this and your phone heats up, you would hope that the glue that holds the rubber foot in place would be able to hold up to that. I mean, I'm not supercharging my phones. It's a Pixel 5. It's not using a lot of power. This is a wireless Qi device that has smart charging, meaning what that does is, depending on the phone that you put on this, is the amount of wattage that will get output. You don't want to fry your phone with 15 watts of charging power if it cannot accept 15 watts. Speaking of charging, what does that actually look like with this particular device? Also, when you have this plugged in, is it drawing any power? Because, well, I came from a place where everything in my house ran on electricity and leaving something plugged in was something I always was concerned about. So let's take a look at that right now. Idling. Negligible amounts of power. Charging. Twelve watts max. Spikes at 14. Wait for that to go back down to zero. Sideways. Caps off at about 12. So the numbers you saw there were pretty much with my phone fully charged, but you did see that the phone will charge both in the upright as well as the horizontal position. So if you want to watch a movie while your phone is charging, you can. You also saw that the charger does work with a case. In particular, this case is the Spigen Tough Armor, review in the corner if you're interested. And I checked two types of tests, one with the case on and one with the case off. And I did find that while I had my case on, it took a full 2 hours to fully charge from 13%, as opposed to an hour and 40 minutes to charge without my case on. So this particular case does add a little buffer, so you're not getting that full connective charge that you would get from here if it was just touching the back of your phone. So when I had it with the back of the phone, it came down closer to the hour 30 that I'd get with plugging in the USB-C directly into my phone. Also, some charging data. I will flash it up on the screen right now. When I first started, and you know, when you first plug in a phone for charging, you have that maximum boost of power. I was getting 2,460 milliamps, And when I got towards the end of the charging and it was slowing down and just about done, it dropped down to 1760 milliamps. So just some data so that you know what you're getting into with this stand. There is a laundry list of slated devices, which I will have down in the description area below, that are compatible with this. Missing is actually my Pixel 5 phone because they just didn't update it, but I will tell you, if you're looking for a charging stand for your Pixel 5, this will work. As somebody who never really thought about charging stands, I've actually been really happy with this particular stand from Anker. Anker does make some great products, so you're not gonna have to really worry about anything. It also comes with a 18-month warranty, so if you have any problems or you're worried about that, 18 months to figure out if there's a problem. Now, the thing to consider, pricing. Well, depending on where you get the Anker PowerWave 2, you're looking to spend anywhere from $35 to $40. If you are in the market for a charging stand, there are other options out there. Some of them are just a pad that lays flat and your phone would sit on your surface like that, as opposed to tilted. So it's really a form factor thing for you. I actually kind of like the upright position here because I can, whenever we go back to work, I can have this next to my computer and see what I need to see on my phone, as opposed to having to lean over to see a pad. Right now, like I said, with my filming setup for YouTube, this has been invaluable. So if you are in the market for a wireless Qi charging stand, I recommend checking out the Anker PowerWave 2 here. With that being said, I have been Wanderer 001. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave them in the area below. And as always, thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful, consider giving it a like, as that will help other people find the video as well. If you like what I'm doing here, you can always help fuel the next review by buying me a coffee, link in the description below. Last but not least, if you want to be notified when I upload a new video, you know what to do.